Modus is an open source serverless framework for building functions and APIs powered by WebAssembly. The easiest way to get started with Modus is by using the Modus CLI. So to start off, let's install the CLI. We can install using the script or from npm. Now, once the CLI is installed, we'll create a new Modus project using the Modus new command. Since Modus is a polyglot framework that compiles to WebAssembly, it currently supports Go and AssemblyScript, which is a TypeScript-like language for WebAssembly. So we'll select AssemblyScript for this example. We'll choose a name for our getting started project. And now the Modus CLI will scaffold out our project. Let's go ahead and open this in a text editor. By default, we start with a bare bones hello world example. The important pieces are the index.ts file and the modus.json file, which declares the AI models, data connections, and other aspects of our project. Let's start our Modus app with the Modus dev command that will build our app and start a GraphQL API locally. So we'll switch over to Postman to inspect and query our GraphQL API. And we can see that the GraphQL schema maps to the function exported by our Modus app. We have a single field, say hello, that takes an optional argument name that can be included in the result of our function. Now, any API needs to work with data, so we'll add a new connection to the ZenQuotes API. Modus has built-in clients for Postgres, dgraph, as well as fetching data from GraphQL or HTTP APIs. So let's go ahead and add a new function that will fetch a random quote from the ZenQuotes API. So we'll need to define a new type quote to represent that quote object. And then our new function getRandomQuote that returns the quote object. When we save this file, we'll notice that our Modus project is rebuilt. And if we switch back to Postman and refresh the schema, we'll see a new query field, random quote. We can add this to our selection set. And when we execute the query, we can see the data returned from the ZenQuotes API. Let's take a look at working with AI models in Modus. We'll update our modus.json manifest to specify the MetaLlama model. So Modus can support AI models like classifiers, embedders, and LLMs. We're going to install the Hype CLI, which will allow us to access hosted models on the Hypermode platform. So in addition to model APIs like OpenAI and Anthropic, we can also leverage the Hypermode platform for hosting models from Hugging Face. We'll just need to sign in or create a free account on Hypermode. Once our project is linked with the Hypermode platform, we can then leverage this model in our Modus app. So let's import some helpers for working with models in Modus. And then I'm going to create a new function. Let's call this generate text that will take user input, how about an instruction and a prompt, and we'll then invoke that and pass that along to our model and return the results. If we save this, our Modus project will be rebuilt. And switch back to Postman, refresh the schema, we can see a new field, generate text in our GraphQL API. That takes two arguments, the instruction and a user prompt. So let's go ahead and ask our model about dgraph. When we execute this query, our model is being invoked on the Hypermode platform. And we should see the results explaining that dgraph is an open source distributed real-time scalable graph database. Well, this was just a quick overview of getting started with Modus to build an intelligent API using functions, data, and models. You can check out the docs for more examples of what you can build. You can follow the project on GitHub to keep up with new features and releases. We'd also love for you to join our community on Discord. We can't wait to see what you build with Modus.